Thank you. This is Meenakshi, and we will start our presentation. With your permission, I'm just putting the video off. I see some network glitch when I'm speaking.
No problem.
Yeah. A very good evening to all of you. My heartiest wishes to all of us on surviving through this pandemic and meeting back to yet another positive conclave here. Thank you, MTC and FNGC. We are honored to present our case study on restructure of storage and SAN infrastructure. We represent Wipro here. We are from Wipro Service Next Operations Center. This is the Wipro's first integrated service platform for remote infrastructure management support, where we support data center infra for 100 plus customers, cutting across 13 plus technical domain and 20 plus services for India and Middle East clients in 24/7 support window, and with this shared pool of resources. I am Meenakshi, leading the quality for RIM, and with me, Venkat, who is the tower lead for one of the critical domain storage, and Aditya is the black belt for this project. We'll pass you through this case study. Pass, and handing over to Venkat.
Thank you, Meenakshi. Storage is a key component of digital devices. As a business, have to store their information related to business critical application and their database information. SAN storage systems are hardware and the software-based data storage and the retrieval system. As we highlighted here, all the internet-based application, all the data flow will happen via server, and those connectivity will happen to the SAN switch. From the data retrieval will happen from your storage system. So they respond to the network SAN request from the server and client and fulfill them by writing data or retrieving data from the disk array. So this picture represents completely that component. So during end of 2019, one of our BFSI major customer, though we were able to meet our service level, there was certain performance degradation was cause of concern, which was echoed in end user voice as well. So we manage a key critical customer storage infrastructure, approximately 28 SAN and storage devices, and put together we have 850 TB of heterogeneous storage infra that span across altogether 9 SAN vendors, like multi-tenants vendor. So therefore, we intend to look at the storage infra holistically and improve business reliability, hence we initiated this project. So over to Aditya.
Thank you, Venkat. Now moving on to the goal of the project. We took a goal of reducing the device uptime to lesser than 90 days, which is the global benchmark, from 761 days. Now, I will tell you why the device uptime should be reduced. Device uptime can be defined as a device continuously operational without any rest and redundancy. High device uptime in the storage infra might lead to slowness in the operation, hardware and smart disk places. And if the device goes down, the same device cannot be brought up immediately. And in turn, it will hamper business continuity. This was exactly what our voice of customer was. Now coming to the CTQs, our project CTQ was device uptime. And the customer CTQ rolled up to high availability of critical storage devices. And our business CTQ is customer satisfaction. So in this slide, we have documented the SIPOC to get the overview of the activities involved. Like I said earlier, the output required from our client was high availability of storage devices, for which we have drafted the detailed process flow. The input for the process comes from the client storage infra. Now moving to the measure phase. We have collected the 12 weeks of data for device uptime. And to check whether the data was normal and stable, we have done the normality test and run chart. We found that the data was normal as well as stable. Through the process capability test, we came to know that current sigma level is very low, which was at -25.54, through which we can also tell that the target of lesser than 90 days of device uptime is statistically significant. Now moving on to the analyze phase. So we started the analyze phase with multiple brainstorming session, including technical expert, customer team, delivery team. Then we listed down all the probable causes through a fishbone diagram. In the next step, we have bifurcated those causes as qualitative and quantitative. For qualitative causes, we have prioritized using multi-voting, whereas for quantitative causes, we have prioritized using statistical tools, which I will explain in the upcoming slides. So here we had the data of device uptime in days against the count of end-of-life storage, count of hardware and smart disk failure cases, and against the count of non-reboot of critical devices. To understand the relationship of these with our device uptime, we did correlation. So since p-value is lesser than 0.05, we can tell that all these causes have a significant correlation with the device uptime. To further analyze these excess and to see whether they are significantly contributing to our Y, we have done the regression. From regression, we can see that p-value is lesser than 0.05 for X1, X2, X4, and X4.1, and the R-square adjusted value of 90.04, which indicates these excess have a major contribution on our Y. So the one more statistical tool which we have used is one sample t-test. Here we had the data of NetApp storages which were running with limited storage space. So what we have took a 12-week data of the storage space. Then the minimum storage space required was 220 TB. Then we did one sample t-test to see whether minimum storage space is available or not. Through the p-value, we can tell that the storage space is below the target, which is not sufficient as well. So I will summarize the analyze phase. We started with the brainstorming session. Then all the causes from the brainstorming session, we had put it in a fishbone diagram. The causes were divided into two categories, qualitative and quantitative. For qualitative, we have done multi-voting and Gemba walk. For quantitative, we have used statistical tools such as one sample t-test, correlation, and regression. So all our root causes can be bifurcated into four main categories, which is limited storage space, network level redundancy, mundane efforts, and process gaps. So for the evaluation and selection of solutions, we have done a brainstorming session and we did probable solutions, and through technical discussions, we have identified the solutions for improvement and implemented. Over to Venkat.
Thank you, Aditya. So I'll take you through how we have adapted Lean and Six Sigma technique to come out of the concerns. So the first is the workload leveling of the NetApp. So if you see the picture here before and after, it clearly states there are NetApp standalone controllers causes the outage to the entire business critical application. We identified those critical applications and migrated those critical applications to HA NetApp controllers. So it helps to increase the scalability and a better performance for business application. So this is artifact. So if you see the first slide, it is only having the controller, which is not having a HA pair. It is a standalone controller. And there is a down slide, 3240A and 3240B. 3240A is a controller. When any application goes down, the same will get failover to 3240B. So this is workload leveling, another one more solution. So workload leveling of ISL. So as we already highlighted, the server means all the internet-based application will go via server and the SAN switch and the storage. Data retrieval will happen from, this is a flowchart. So there are certain ISL links which overutilized causes a huge bottleneck to the application slowness. Since some of the critical servers were running multi databases in the same server, where it required more data bandwidth for read and write operations. So we identified and enabled the additional link between the switches of the servers and storages. So the data retrieval between the server and the storages will happen via this through SAN switches, since we have enabled the multiple ISL link. So there are means spare disk unavailability causes the outage to the data loss. Okay, so we identified there are certain NetApp storages where they don't have enough spare disk. We added the record spare disk to the business continuity. So automation. So we were preparing the daily health report manually for all the highlighted storage and the SAN devices. To eliminate this mundane task, prepare the automated script and enable that automated script to the respective stakeholders. It consists of all hardware and software.
10 minutes.
Software consolidated report, as well the individual storage ways. Move on to next slide. Okay. So this is a consolidated review report. So network level redundancy. So few of the NetApp storages were connected to the single SAN switches. Okay, single network switch, which caused the outage to the business application, even though storage level redundancy is enabled, which we have highlighted in earlier slide. Even the network level redundancy, by failovering the storage controller within minimum downtime, even though the data was spanned across multiple storages. So those all are the storages as highlighted here. And these all are the health report done for those storages. We standardize the practice of rebooting the storage devices. It helps to get the better performance from the SAN devices and reduce the performance issue. So we have decommissioned, as a part of this particular project, we have decommissioned close to 4 storages and SAN switches in the infra. Also enable the standard practice of submitting the overall asset inventory, including the EOL devices to customer on through monthly MIS report. Okay, so we fixed some of the hardware and SmartX failure by coordinating with the respective OEM as a part of this project. Also, we standardized the process of infra monitoring. So over to Aditya.
We have monitored our excess using IMR chart. If we see here, all the excess are stable and well within upper control limit and lower control limit. As a testimony to our efforts, our sigma value has improved from -25.4 to 2.13. Also, we have statistically validated our improvement and it is significant. We have chalked out a detailed sustenance plan for the same. Over to Meenakshi.
Post implementing all the solution, we re-looked at the result. And as we were so far discussing about the value which has come up to customer by optimizing the storage rack, it was worth of $166K. And alongside, Wipro got benefited of $33K by one-time revenue realization, where customer opted to give us this implementation and execution and value for the services. Along with that, we have also assured the redundancy of complete client infrastructure, which has enabled them to operate during the pandemic situation with high availability, which is improved to 100% and with zero major incidents since last 10 months with the storage infrastructure, which was depicted in their CSAT consistently. And our CSAT score were above 6.2 over the period. And a specific question to the COVID support was responded by the customer in an overwhelming way. We have also contributed to an environment optimizing the end-of-life devices and disconnecting them from the data center environment, improving thereby the DCO operation and also contributing to the power saving. We have some appreciation during this COVID support with this all innovation and innovative coming innovations and tech automations bringing to their infrastructure for this major insurance sector, which is depicted from their seniors' appreciation to our team. So this is what we brought the value for the customer as well as our organization got benefited with this initiative. And with this, we are ending our presentation. We will be happy to take the questions.
Okay, thank you, team. This is Sachin. I have a small question. How many of the, probable causes which were quantitative in nature, how many of those causes is data was readily available to you for doing any kind of statistical analysis, and how many of them had to be collected during the project?
Yeah. Aditya, if we can go to the table.
Yeah.
And answer this.
Yes, I can answer this. For us, the quantitative causes like data, like count of end of life storage, count of hardware and smart disk failures, and the count of NetApp storages running without dependency because of limited space was it was readily available. But it was readily available as in we had to put some efforts to get the data. We had to perform a capacity study to get the limited storage space. What was the storage space trend for the last 12 weeks? And also manually, we had to open the incident report and check the how many hardware and smart disk failures have happened in the last 12 days. So as such, it was readily available as in it was there, but we had to go and dig it out.
Specifically, where we have to log into the devices and collect the data, There we have taken the help of complete team of Venkat, and they have given us the data.
Thank you for your response.
Hi, Meenakshi and team. First of all, a good presentation, a very structured work there.
Thank you.
I have a question. It has two parts. Want to understand when we talk about, you know, basic flaws like which you identified in your process regarding non-reboot and NetApp migration, how much of it was attributed to the basic process failure, which should have actually been there in place by default as a primary SLA for you? And how much of it, and the second part of the question is, was it, the NetApp migration and the other solutions that you're looking at, was it something innovative or was it catching up with the competition?
Ma'am, I'll take this. Sure, Venkat. I would like to answer the first question. So this customer infra, we have close to around some 28 storage and SAN devices. Okay, so since it is highly critical, we do recommend for the customer a planned reboot for the scheduled downtime. So there are certain scenarios for some storages, non-critical storages, we get the downtime. There are certain storages we not even get the downtime. Overall, if you see, there are certain storage component where we had a uptime of close to 1,300 plus days as well. So those storages, we could not able to get a downtime, but as a part of this project, we have initiated and we have reconsolidated their entire data center. Like they were having close to some 40 plus racks, and we have reconsolidated and brought it down to 25 racks. So each rack space where we have done the reconsolidation from the storage, from the server, from the network, and overall, we enable the labeling as well as the structure way of for from with respect to the network also high availability enabled. So mm-hmm. With respect to process related stuff, there are certain challenging downtimes with respect to all the devices. It's not only from the storage component here we talk about the server, there are patching need to be done. We talk about the network device, there some soup upgrade need to be done. Those upgrade would have been not done from quite some time because this particular customer will run the data on network also, apart from the fiber channel. There are two components, a network data transfer as well as fiber channel data transfer. So due to the network stack, they cannot take any downtime because even the end user flow also will come across in the same data. So this is with respect to the process.
If you can go to the workload leveling slide, please. If I understood his question correctly, sir, the basic process related issue, what you said, which will be having some dependency from the client, some dependency from the downtime that Venkat has explained related to the calendarized or structurized reboot schedule or capacity planning. Apart from that, if you see the major transformation has brought in by this solution, this is the one of the solution. Venkat, if you want to talk about this and the port migration.
Just go back. Yeah, keep it in this slide only, Aditya. So there are certain applications where they were running in the single NetApp controller. It was there from the quite long time, even though we planned for a downtime, we did not even get. But as a part of this particular project, we have migrated this one in live. Means from the storage level, we replicated the data from this controller to the partner controller also, the same NetApp flavor. And we have migrated. But
and point to be noted here is no additional cost has been incurred by the client. We have right. used so, okay, existing fine. Infrastructure.
Sorry, just got it. Just in the interest of time, I'll have to stop it here. But I got the gist of what you're saying. Specifically,
Umesh, just a line to add to this. You mentioned about our SLAs, right? When we initiated this project, our SLAs were completely green. The customer had this concern in mind, and this was executed in the first phase of the pandemic. So the customers were really concerned, like during the pandemic, if at all, if one of our storage system goes down, how do we handle it? And many of our critical storage devices are not performing with the full capacity. That's where this whole idea came into the picture, and we along with the customer team, we brainstormed this project. And for the customer also, from the day one, we have told them we are following a Six Sigma methodology for it, for which we have a mail artifact also.
I think not
data. Sure. Okay. Thank you, team.
Thank you.